Good morning, students. Today you are going to deal with chapter 9, that is ratio and proportions, grade 6. Hope all of you are fine. Yes, so we can start with the chapter. Today I will be doing the introduction of the chapter. Okay, ratio and proportion. Now ratio, what is it? It's nothing but comparison. You are comparing two quantities. Normally in daily life, what happens? Okay, your brother is very bright. So mother often, your father often says, see, look at Vivek, how bright he is. He is always getting full marks. What about you? Why can't you? Yes. Otherwise, your sister or cousin, she is a good dancer. Srishti, see that? She is a good dancer. You can also learn Kathak. You can be a good dancer. Or else, see that she is good in, or he is good in music. Isn't it? This is comparison that we know that. Because we are used to comparing, isn't it? See that how long hair that girl is having. See my hair, isn't it? You often compare things. So in the number of the world of numbers, we compare, and comparison is called ratio. So today's topic is ratio and proportion. So first one is ratio. What is it, ratio? When you compare two quantities and the two quantities should have same unit. Suppose A is one quantity and B is another quantity, both are having same units, then we say that A ratio B, that is, we have put two dots, it is read as A is to B. Okay, so A is to B or A ratio B. We are comparing both quantities A and B. So for comparison, both the quantities should have same units. And this is ratio is nothing but a fraction. So we are comparing it by division, that is A by B or A ratio B. So we are comparing it with by division, that is A. So ratio is nothing but a fraction. Now if I am telling you, I have studied for 20 minutes. Okay. And my brother has studied more. That is, he has studied 80 minutes in it. Okay, in a day. Now, how will I compare? Units are same, both are in minutes. So, I will compare it. It is 20 upon 80. So, 20 upon 80. You can cancel both the zeros. Now, ratio is a fraction. Again, I am telling you. So, what happens? You can take the common factor. So, 2 by 8. What is the common factor? It is 2. So, it is 1 by 4. So, how will you express 1 by 4 in ratio? It is 1 is to 4. So this one. Now, if I have got only 5 kg of sugar at my place, and suppose Sneha has got 20 kg of sugar, maybe her birthday or something, so mother has arranged. So I have got 5 kg of sugar and Sneha has got 20 kg of sugar. Yeah, 25 kg of sugar, suppose. So, how will I compare? Who has got more or how much more, etc. Comparison happens. So, it is 5 kg upon 25 kg. Now, what is the unit of ratio? Ratio doesn't have any unit. Why? Because I will show you. 5 kg upon 25 kg. Kg upon, I told you we will compare this with the same quantities. So, kg, kg, you have to cancel it. Now, 5 upon this one. So it is 1 by 5. So how will I put it in ratio? It is 1 ratio 5. So what happens is that Sneha has got 5 times more than the quantity I have got. Isn't it? 5 times more, because I have got 5 kg and she has got 25 kg. So 1 ratio 5 means it's 5 times more than the quantity I have got. So, hope you understood. Ratio is nothing but fraction and you have to compare it. And for comparison, you have to have the same unit. Suppose, how will you compare one day with 6 hours? Okay. So, if I say, ask you, find the ratio between one day and 6 hours. So, one day. How many hours one day has got? One day is equal to 24 hours. So now both the quantities have same unit, because hours. So it is 24 upon 6, that is 4 upon 1. So 4 ratio 1, isn't it? 4 ratio 1. Now if it is 20
seconds to 2 minutes. How will you find the ratio? Now, my students, you know, in 1 minute, how many seconds are there? 60. So, 2 minutes, it will be 60 into 2. That is 120 minutes. Now, 120 seconds. So, 120 seconds and 20 seconds. How will you compare it? 20 upon 120. So, 20 upon 120, 0, 0 cancels 2 and this is 1 by 6. So, what is the ratio between 20 seconds and 2 minutes? You have to first convert to the same unit and now you got the answer as 1 ratio 6. So, hope you understood because ratio is nothing but comparison. It is a fraction and it doesn't have any unit. So, when you are comparing two quantities, it should have the same units. First, you will convert it to same unit. Then you will compare. Okay. So, you will find. Now, what are equivalent ratios? So, equivalent ratios. Yes, we are coming to the topic equivalent ratios. Before that, I told you ratio is nothing but fraction. So, my students, already you have learned the chapter fraction and you know equivalent fractions. Isn't it? So, if I say 1 ratio 2, write 3 equivalent ratios for 1 ratio 2. How will you make? You have to multiply or divide on both sides the same quantity. So, 1 ratio, this one is 1 by 2. So, you will multiply the denominator with 10. Then, the denominator should also be multiplied numerator with 10. So, the denominator should also be, that is 10 by 20. So, it is written as 10 is to 20. This is the first one. So, if I multiply with 5, what happens? 1 ratio 2. So, 1 into 5. So, I have to multiply the second into 5. This is 5 is to 10. So, what is it? My second one is 5 is to 10. Now, third one. If I multiply with 100, what happens? It is 100 is to 200. Okay. So, this is the third one. So, I got 3 equivalent ratios. Now, equivalent ratios. See, when I simplify, I should get this one. 1 is to 2. Isn't it? So, we have done with equivalent ratio. Now, we will be doing one more so that you will be thorough with the topic. Isn't it? Equivalent ratio. So, suppose 3 is to 5. Now, what happens? I am asking you to find out 2 equivalent ratios. So, you can multiply it with 2. So, here also with 2, what happens is that 6 is to 10. So, 6 is to 10 is the first one. Now, if I am multiplying with 9, so I should multiply 5 also with 9. 9 threes are, it is 27, 5 nines are 45. So, what happens to second? Second is 27 ratio. So, if I multiply with 1000 on both sides, what happens? 3 into 1000 is 3000 is 2, 5 into 1000 is 5000. So, I got 3, isn't it? So, ratio is nothing but fraction and equivalent ratio, same way you are multiplying both the terms. Now, the terms, there are two terms, isn't it? In the ratio, that is first term is A and second term is B. So, A ratio B or A is to B. The first one is called antecedent. First one is the first term or antecedent you are then. Okay, this is the first term or antecedent. And second, that is B. B is called second term. It is called second term or consequent. Or consequent. Okay, consequent or second term. So, the first term or second term or antecedent or consequent. So, two terms are there. Now, equivalent ratio, hope you understood. Now, we will go for the next topic. It is called proportion. So, proportion. When can you say ratios are in proportion? Ratios are in proportion when both ratios are equal. So, when two ratios are equal, you say they are in proportion. Two ratios are equal means you say that they are in proportion. Suppose 2 ratio 4. In proportion, you will put 4 dots. Instead of 2, in case of ratio, there are 2 dots, one below the other. Here, you will have 4 dots. Okay. So, 2 ratio 4 is in proportion with 4 ratio 8. So, how will you... that is, I told you there should be equal ratios. Isn't it? 2 ratios are equal, then they are in proportion. So, we can find it. What is it? This is 2 by 4. 2 by 4 is 1 by 2. What about this one? 4 by 8. 4 by 8 is 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 equal to 1 by 2. So they are in proportion. So 2 ratio 4 is in proportion with 4 ratio 8. So I hope you understood proportion. Now if it is another one, if I am giving you another one, that is 2 ratio 5 is in proportion with 20 ratio 50. Are they in proportion? Yes. How will you find out? You can just, this is 2 by 5 and what it is? 20 by 50. 20 by 50, you can cancel out the common factor. That is 0, 0 cancels. It is equal to 2 by 5. So both are equal. So 2 ratio 5 is in proportion with 20 ratio 50. So equivalent ratios, they are called proportion. So now the next topic we are having in the chapter is unitary method. What is it? Unitary method. Okay. Unitary method. Nothing. Nothing serious. It's very simple. What is it? Unit. Unit means it's one. Okay. One unit. That is unit equals one. So if you are asked to find the cost of 10 pence, if the cost of 2 pence are given, how will you find out? You will first find the cost of 1 pen, then you will multiply for finding the cost of more pens. So we are going to do how much? How will you do? Suppose I am telling you 2 pence cost rupees 50. Okay, 2 pence. The cost of 2 pence are rupees 50. Now I am asking you what is the cost of 15 pence. How will you find the cost of 15 pence? So how will you find out the cost of 15 pence? I told you 2 pence cost 50. So cost of 2 pence equals rupees 50. So 2 pence cost 50. So what is cost of 1 pen? Yes, cost of 1 pen equals 50 divided by 2. That means more to 1, then we will divide. Okay, that is we will divide. More to 1 means you will divide. So 50 by 2, that is 25, rupees 25. Now, what is asked? 15 pence cost. So cost of 15 pence. Now, from 1 pen, you have to find the cost of 15 pence. So from 1 to more, what you have to do? Just the opposite of division. What is opposite of division? It is multiplication. So 1 to more means you had to multiply. So what is the amount you got? Amount you got it as 25. So 25 into 15. How much it is? 25 into 15. You will multiply it. 5 as a 25. Balance 2. 5 2s are 10. 12. 1 5s are 5. 1 2s are 2. It is 573. It is rupees 375. Okay. Rupees 375. What did you do? Unitary method. First find the cost of 1 pen, then find the cost of 15 pence. So we will do one more regarding this one. So if 5 kg of sugar, okay, that is 5 kg of sugar cost rupees 300. Okay, rupees 300 the cost. Okay, so I have to find cost of 30 kg of sugar. I have to find 30 kg of sugar. What is the cost? So how will you find? First I have to find the cost of 1 kg of sugar. So cost of 5 kg of sugar equals rupees 300. Now cost of 1 kg. 1 kg equals rupees 300. I told you when it is many to 1, you have to divide. So divide by 5. How much it is? 60. Isn't it? Now, you are asked find the cost of 30 kg of sugar. So, you are asked 30 kg of sugar. What is the cost? So, from 1 to many, you had to multiply. So, what is the value? It is rupees 60 into 30. 0, 0, 6, 3 are 18. So, rupees 1800. So, how much you got? So, unitary method. So, what did you deal with this today? Today, you have dealt with a new chapter. That new chapter is ratio and proportion. Now, ratio is just comparing two quantities having same
unit. Okay, and then you have found out ratio doesn't have any unit, then you have found out equivalent ratios. Equivalent ratios means like equivalent fractions, you can multiply on both sides the same, yeah, divide on both sides, right? Then you have found out what is proportion. Equivalent ratios are called proportion, isn't it? Okay, now the last is the topic you have dealt with is unitary method. That means finding the value of one quantity, then finding the value for many quantities. So unit means one. Okay, so today you have done the introduction and the content of the whole chapter. Okay, tomorrow onwards you will be doing the exercises. Okay, hope so. Revise that. Thank you. Bye bye.